Good morning. In today's session, we are supposed to study about the mean value, autocorrelation, and the spectral density of the random process. So, in previous session, we have seen about the random process. It is the collections of the random variable. If we are giving these random variables the function of time, at that time, we are saying that collections of the random variable as a random process. And mathematically, we are deriving random process as it is defined as collections of the time functions together with the probability rule, which will assign probability to any meaningful event associated with observation of one of the sample function of x of t. So here we are giving meaningful event to the sample functions that can be statistical parameter. So here we are supposed to derive these statistical parameter. So here we will needed qualitative measure to specify the random process. If we are taking x of t, that is taking as a random process, you can see here the waveform. We are taking the x of t, that is the random process. So here we are supposed to derive analytical expression for the random process, but this may not always be possible. In some situations where collections is obtained experimentally, we must find some qualitative measures that will specify the random process. So here, when we are taking random process as a collections of the random variable, at that time we are saying these are generally dependent. But here we are supposed to use PDF of this random variable. PDF is nothing but the probability distribution functions. So here we are saying we are taking the random process as a ensemble of the time functions together with a probability rule that will assign probability to any meaningful event that will associated with observations of one of the sample function of x of t. So here we are saying we will needed the PDF, probability distributions functions of random variable. So here firstly we will see about the mean value. At that time you can observe the waveform here. If we are taking the random process x of t, so for a random process x of t we will define the mean value that can be defined as expected value of a random variable, which we will get by observing the process at some time, because mean is nothing but when we are studying about the mean in the statistics, in the mathematics. At that time what we are taking in the mean, we are supposed to take the average, but here we are supposed to take the average of the time functions. How we are supposed to take for the some sample values? So if we are taking the random process x of t, at that time we can define mean that can be the expected value of a random variable, which we will get by observing the process at some time t. So here we are taking on the x-axis time, on the y-axis if you see we are taking there the random process. So here we will get the mean, or you can say the average. The mean value of the random variable we will get by observing the process at time. So here the mean value you can denote by x bar, you can denote m suffix x of t. It means what? That will be the mean of x of t. So here you will get that as limit t tends to infinite 1 integration from 0 to t x of t dt. So here we can say the mean value, that is the height of the rectangular area
which will have some same area that under the function x of t. So we can call mean value as first moment of the probability distributive functions. So we can calculate mean value of the random process like limit t tends to infinite 1 of t 0 to t x of t dt. X of t is nothing but it is the random process, t the total time. So here we are taking from 0 to t, so on that we are supposed to take that as a, it will be the function of time. So you will get here the mean. So here we will see about the mean square value, variance and the standard deviation of the random process. Mean square value, the variance and the standard deviations of the random process. So here we are taking the same diagram again. We are taking on the x-axis the time and the on y-axis we are taking the random process. So here we are supposed to calculate the mean square value. We have derived already the mean. How we will get? You will get limit t tends to infinite integration 0 to t x of t dt. So here we are supposed to take mean square value. So that will be the mean square. So you can take x square, you will get limit t tends to infinite 1 of t 0 to t integrations x square of t dt. Now we are supposed to study about the auto correlations and auto covariance. So here now we can talk about the variance. So you will get the variance that will be analogous to the autocorrelations, because if we are taking the autocorrelations of the random process at two times, simply if we are taking at two times, you can take at t1 and t2. So you will get the correlations of two random variables. This will be x of t1 and x of t2. So we can say if we are talking about the covariance of the random process at that time, you will get variance. You will get that will be sigma x square equal to x of t minus x bar. That is nothing but x of t is the random process. X bar is the mean of random process and whole square. So you will get limit t tends to infinite 1 of t 0 to t x of t minus x bar whole square dt. So here you are taking the average of square of deviations. Average of the square of deviations of x of t from the mean value. So you will get the variance of the random process. So here we are denoting standard deviations that we are taking sigma x is the square root of a variance. So here you will get the variance value that will be equal to, you will get x of t minus x bar whole square. So now we can see about the autocorrelations. So you can see here about the autocorrelations. If we are taking the autocorrelations or autocovariance that will describe the general dependency of the random process with its value at a short time. So if we are taking pulse is shifted over toe at that time. Over short time, that will be the toe at that time. If we are calculating the autocorrelations and the autocovariance, it will give us how random process will depend with that time. So if we are taking these sample values are get over short time, that is nothing but after time t, that will go toe, you can see the waveform. So here you will get sigma x of 2, that is the autocorrelations. You will get that limit t tends to infinite, 1 of t, 0 to t, x of t, bar of x, means mean of random process, into x of t plus sigma minus x bar dt. So here you can say the value of sigma x tau at tau is equal to 0. It is the variance. So you will get here sigma x square. So you can directly get normalized autocorrelations that will be equal to r of t, that will be equal to sigma x tau upon sigma x square. So here you are taking r0 equal to 1. So here we are saying the autocorrelations of the random process, if we are taking at two times t1 and t2 at that time, you can take, you will get the correlations of the two random variable x of t1 and x of t2. So you will get that. How you will get? You will get autocorrelation. So you can denote like e of x of t1, x of t2, that will be equal to r x of t1, x of t2. So here you will get how these are correlated with each other. So here if you see the waveform, you can see here, so you will get, if we are taking the time on the x-axis, here we are saying time lag, and on the y-axis we are supposed to take r of 2, that is nothing but autocorrelation. So here the autocorrelations for the random process eventually decays to 0 at large tau. If they are going beyond time t, that will be tau. So you will get here autocorrelations eventually decays to 0 if we are taking the large value of tau. And you can say the autocorrelations for sinusoidal process, that is nothing but the deterministic. It is a cosine function which does not decay to 0. You can observe here the waveform for the autocorrelations. You are taking r of t autocorrelations on the y of t, y-axis. So here you will get t1 equal to 0 to infinite integration r of tau d tau. So here we can say the area under the normalized autocorrelations function for the fluctuating wind velocity measured at a point, and it will be a measure of average time scale of it is being carried past the measurement point. We are taking that as a t1. So if we are assuming that eddies are being swept past at the mean velocity, so t1 will be the measure of average length scale of the eddies. So you will get, this will be called as a integral length scale, and you will denote that by L of u. Now we are supposed to study about the spectral density of random process. So here we are saying, if we are taking on the x-axis the frequency, and the y-axis we are supposed to take the spectral density. So here you will get the spectral density, that is the autospectral density, power spectral density, or a spectrum density, that will describe the average frequency content of a random process. So here, like a mean, we are taking the average, but instead of time, we are supposed to take the average frequency content. So here, you will get spectral density, that will be sigma x square equal to, you will get 0 to infinite integration s of x n dn. Here we are saying sigma x, so here you will get the quantity sx of n do of n, that will represent the contribution to sigma x square from the frequency increment. So here you will get the unit for the spectral density, that will be equal to unit of x square into
Second, so here if we are calculating the spectral density mathematically, you will get the equations limit t tends to infinite 2 of t modulations x of t of n, because here instead of time you are supposed to take frequency functions. So you will be, your function will be x of t of n and modulus square. So here you will get the spectral density. So where you are taking x of t of n, that is the Fourier transform of the process, random process x of t, that will be taken over the time interval minus t by 2 up to plus t by 2. And the above relationship is the basis for the usual method obtaining the spectral density of a experimental data. So usually here we are using the fast Fourier algorithm to derive the spectral density of a random process. So here when we are talking about the spectral density of a random process, you will get Sx of n, that will be equal to 2 integration minus infinite to infinite sigma x of 2. Sigma is nothing but we are taking as a standard deviation, or we can say as a covariance. So here you will get spectral density Xs of n equal to 2 integration minus infinite to infinite. You will get here rho x tau e to the power minus j 2 pi n tau d sigma. So here we are saying spectral density is the twice of the Fourier transform of autocorrelation functions, and you will get the inverse relationship. For that you can take that inverse relationship. So here you can say spectral density and the autocorrelations are closely linked, because they are basically provide the same information about the random process. You will get n of x of 2 equal to real integration 0 to infinite s of x n e to the power I 2 pi n tau dn. So here you can say the spectral density and the autocorrelations are the correlated with each other. Now we can see about the cross correlation and the covariance of the random process. So here if you see the waveform, you will get the cross correlations functions that will describe the general dependency of the random process with another random process. If we are taking random process one x of t and we are taking other random process y of t, so cross correlation means what? Which will describe the general dependency of x of t, the random process, with another random process y of t plus 2. So here if you see which x of t is depend on the another random process which is delayed by time delay 2. So here we are taking another random process as a y of t plus 2, because we are saying that process will be delayed by time 2. So you will get cross correlations of x of t with y of t plus 2. You will get as c of xy 2, that will be equal to limit t tends to infinite 1 by t integration 0 to t x of t minus x bar. That will be the, you are taking the correlations for x of t. Now you are supposed to take cross correlations. So here you are supposed to take the value for y of t plus 2. So you can take y of t plus 2 minus y bar. It means what? The mean of y dt. So here you will get the cross correlations which will describe how x of t will depend on the another random process which will delayed by 2, y of t plus 2. So here now we can see about the covariance. So here we are saying covariance is nothing but it is the cross correlations functions with time delay 2 which will set to 0. So here you will get Cxy of tau ki jagah tumhe kya milega? Cxy of 0, because here we are taking the cross correlation functions
only with the time delay tau, which will give us, which will set to zero value. So you will get C x y of 0 equal to bar of x dash of t y dash of t. So here you are supposed to integration of that. How you can take limit t tends to infinite 1 by t in bracket x of t minus x bar in another bracket y of t minus y bar dt. So here you will get x dash of t and y dash of t are used to denote the fluctuating parts of the x of t and y of t. So here we have finished about the cross correlations and the covariance. Now we can see about the correlations coefficients. So correlation coefficient is the covariance. So you will get the correlation coefficient rho, that will be, it is the covariance normalized by standard deviations of x and y. Standard deviation of x, sigma x. Standard deviation of y, sigma y. So here we are supposed to solve equation for the correlation coefficient. So we are denoting correlations coefficient by letter n. So you will get correlations coefficient neta bar equal to neta vector, not a neta bar. You are supposed to take here correlation coefficient. So you will get that equal to covariance. That is the covariance normalized by standard deviation of x and y. So you will get in numerator covariance. So you can take bar of x dash of t, y dash of t. Jaise humne yahan pe covariance solve kiya tha. Like that you are supposed to take. And now in denominator you are supposed to take standard deviation of x and y. So you can take sigma x dot sigma y. So when x and y are identical to each other, at that time the value of sigma is plus 1. So you can see you will get the correlations. That will be the full correlations. And if y of t equal to minus x of t, the value of rho will become minus 1. So we can say in general you will get the value of rho will be in between minus 1 to plus 1. Remaining we will see in the next class. Thank you.